Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today we're gonna show you how to perform a website security check. It's no small surprise that security has become a significant concern for web developers and site owners. In this video, we can help you determine how secure your site is right now. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right then, let's get started. One quick and easy way to check your site for malware and vulnerabilities is to use an online scanner. These remotely scan your site and identify common issues. It's super convenient since it doesn't require any software or plugins and only takes a few seconds. There are dozens of scanners to choose from online, but for now, let's pick a popular one that's easy to use, Security Site Check. Once you scan your site, Security will check it against block lists, look for obvious issues like injected spam or out-of-date software, and briefly scan any code it can access for malware. It also offers some suggestions to harden your site against attacks. Tools like this are a great launching point for detecting hidden malware and other issues. While online scanners work well enough, it's even better to install a plugin that's capable of digging deep into the root of your code and fishing out vulnerabilities or hard-to-detect malware. Some popular security plugins you might want to try are All-in-One, WP Security and Firewall, and the most downloaded on the repository, WordFence Security. Once you've installed your plugin of choice, it will likely instruct you to run a scan immediately. The upside of these plugins over remote scanners is that they can remove malware and make changes automatically. If you suspect or know that your site has been infected by malware, pinpointing the source can sometimes be challenging. Here are a few unexplained challenges you may notice, as well as the files hackers are typically attracted to. Sudden links to strange websites you didn't add yourself, new articles and pages you didn't create, or the content of existing pages suddenly changing, changes to settings you didn't make, a new user, especially one with high-level privileges you didn't add, plugins or themes you didn't install. Malware can often inject a malicious code into your files. Check plugin and theme files, the WP content uploads folder. And finally, WordPress core files located in an incorrect directory, WP config, PHP, and HT access. You should back up your site and have an understanding of the code before making any sensitive changes. If you connect to your site with FTP, you can sort by recently modified files for code that shouldn't be there. If your site is infected periodically with malware and you can't find any cause in the files, the issue may be with your server or another site on your server. As we've already mentioned, out-of-date software is by far the most common vector of infection in WordPress. If there's only one thing you can do to keep your site safe, it should be to keep WordPress updated. The easiest way to check the status of all software on your site is to go to Dashboard Updates, which will alert you if your core, theme, or plugins are out of date. As WordPress now performs automatic updates since version 5.5, nothing should be outdated unless you have an outdated version of WordPress. If you don't, you can update everything from this screen. If you know there's a new version of WordPress, but it isn't showing up, click the Check Again button below Current Version. You can also check your plugins, installed plugins, or appearance, themes pages for updates. It's also essential to keep PHP up to date, especially if you're using a version older than 7.3, as it can present significant security vulnerabilities. A weak password on your main account makes it easy for anyone to break into your site with brute-forcing programs, giving them administrator access and the ability to change anything. While a complicated password can be arduous to remember, making logging in less convenient, it's even more inconvenient to have to recover your site from a hack. It's definitely worth using a more secure password even if you have to keep it written down. Your password should use a mix of uppercase and lowercase letters, numbers, and symbols. It'll be best if you did not base it on dictionary words or personal guessable information, such as your address or family member's name. In the best case scenario, your password would be a long, tangled string of random characters. We strongly recommend you use a password manager. Use a site like 1Password or LastPass to generate a secure, unguessable password. You can update your password and email in WordPress by going to Users, All Users, or straight to Users, Profile. Scroll down and find Email under Contact Info and New Password under Account Management. While you're on the Users page, take a look at all your users and make sure there's no one there who you don't recognize or has inappropriate permissions. You should immediately remove any unidentified user with admin permissions. We also encourage you look at this guide on restricting user permissions so only your account will be able to change sensitive files on your site. If your SSL certificate is out of date, you'll usually instantly know. Browsers like Google Chrome will block access to your site with a huge warning about the expired certificate. If you're not sure or already getting this error, check your SSL certificate to see if it's up to date and whether you're using the latest version of SSL TLS. When you visit a website, you'll see a lock icon in the address bar on most browsers. If your certificate is expired, this lock may be red or have a slash through it. Click the lock icon, then click again to see certificate information, including its expiration date. You can also use an SSL certificate checker to scan your site to make sure your certificate isn't expired and there are no vulnerabilities present in your SSL protocol. Many WordPress sites are filled with tiny vectors for attacks that may seem innocuous but can provide more information than you want to share. Having a visible WordPress version in your front end tells hackers exactly what vulnerabilities are present on your site. Especially if you're using an outdated version of WordPress, you may want to hide this information. You'll notice file editors under Appearance, Theme Editor, and Plugins, Plugin Editor, in your backend. While these tools are very convenient, it also makes it suitable for anyone who hacks your site to break something, so you may want to turn them off. You can do so by adding this function to wp-config-php. SQL injections are a common way of breaking into a site. If you have any forms or other user input, restrict the use of special characters and allow only safe, common file types to be uploaded. Finally, for any extra layer of protection, you can password protect file directories. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our WordPress expert engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.